Ah, the Dell computer. A pinnacle of modern computing. No, not really. But I like these things, and I love to restore them and get them up to working condition, get them ready to play some games. None of them are really that powerful, and I don't expect any of them to run Crysis at the maximum settings, but they all work for the kind of games I like to play with my friends. And that's what we're going to do today. We're going to upgrade one of these machines. Now, if you've been very observant, you might have noticed that they're all labeled. I like to name them all after towns in RuneScape. For example, this machine here is Edgeville. It's a lower spec machine, but it's the one I play the most Quake 3 on, as you can see from the etching on the side. I have more powerful computers that I like to play bigger games on, like Lumbridge, which is a reasonably high spec machine. Canifus, which is pretty much the same setup as Lumbridge, but it's running an Intel Core 2 processor rather than a Pentium dual core. Now these are my Optiplexes. I've got a lot of these, and one of these is going to be what we're going to upgrade today. This one here is specifically Varric, and is running a very old GeForce card. This is Falador, which is running the exact same card and specs as Varric. All of the machines all run Core 2 Duos running at 1.86 GHz. Every one of these Optiplex machines runs the same CPU. This here is Karumja, and this doesn't have any dedicated graphics. This is running solely on its integrated Intel GMA graphics, which are pretty hopeless for most things. This here is Camelot, which is a small form factor machine that runs a Pentium dual core, but it's at least got a dedicated 5450 Radeon, which is a great little card for the money. And this one can certainly handle bigger games than a lot of the machines here. This is one I picked up from a garage sale recently, Morton. It runs a dedicated Radeon and a reasonable Pentium, actually. It was originally designed for Vista, but I've put 7 on it now. This is Draenor. Draenor is perhaps one of the slowest machines I have, as I haven't even upgraded the RAM. But it runs Quake and Halo fine, and that's the main two games that I play on these machines. This is Lighthouse. This is the main gaming rig that I use. It runs an R9 270X and has around 8 gigs of RAM. As much as the sticker dictates, it says it's designed for Windows 98, but it runs 7, and it runs a dual-core i3 at 3.4 GHz. This here's Brimhaven. This is running an older Radeon as well, but it's one of the Optiplex machines. This is Barbarian. I took this from an old council cleanup heap, and it's a Lenovo machine. Now, which one? These two are the ones we're going to probably upgrade, so we're going to pick one of these. Probably sticking with that one, because it's the most clean. Basically, it's a normal spec'd out machine with 2 gigs of RAM, a 1.86 Core 2 Duo, and pretty much no extra graphics capability or no hard drive. So we're probably going to have to get it a hard drive and graphics. But the power supply is certainly powerful enough to support a low power card, and there's the spare slot there. Opening it up, you can see the giant cooler for the CPU, which keeps the CPU very, very cool. Down there you can see the PCIe slot that we're going to put the new card. So we're going to go off the shops now to get a reasonably cheap graphics card for the machine, and also a 500 gig hard drive, possibly. finally parking the car and finding a spot, I'm going to head into Octogon Electronics and hopefully pick up a GT630 or a GT640 for the machine, which are low-power GeForce cards. Now, I intended for a 640, but I came out with a 730. This is the pawn shop where I like to get my hard drives. They're very cheap. And now on the way home, this is what we got. We got a GeForce GT730 with 2 gigs of DDR video memory, which is a pretty decent card for 99 bucks. We get a second-hand 500 gig HITACHI 7200 RPM hard drive, and of course a stick of 2 gigs of RAM for DDR2, which is the older RAM for this machine. So first of all, we're going to whack that hard drive straight into this blue sockety thing that Dell installed. Now, there's no real special technique to these things. You just pretty much stretch them and line them up with the small holes in the hard drive and slip it in. Once the hard drive's installed, you put it in upside down, which is strange, but that's how it works. And then you pop in the SATA power and SATA cable. Here we go. Now we're putting in the GeForce card. It's got a pretty big cooler, but it should be small enough to fit in the machine. I really don't want to make another trip back to the shops. Dell has this little mounting bracket, so there's no screws. You just put in the card and then secure that. Then the card's in. Now with the card secure, we have to put a bit of the extra 2 gigs of RAM in the machine. I'm sorry, it's really hard to see this bit, but pretty much just line the RAM up and put it in. Now closing up the machine, we're going to pop it down and give it a boot. We're plugging in the VGA and the keyboard and mouse, and the power, and let's give it a boot. Into BIOS we can see that it hasn't had any errors yet, and it's happily picked up our extra stick of memory that we've put in, which is great. The machine's also picked up the GeForce and is transmitting through that now, so that's a good sign. So we're going to make sure that it's booting straight to the CD drive, and we're going to install Windows. We want to stick with the Australian time currency and get this installed. We want to choose the x86 version, because the x64 version can have some compatibility problems with the older games that I play, like Quake. So we're going to go with x86. Accept that. I've clearly read all of that. Custom. And oh, it's picked up the drive, very good. We can format the drive, make sure it's going to be ready for our install and not have any problems. Now that it's done, we're just going to start the install and come back once it's done. Here we go, the install is done, and it's restarted, and I've skipped a bit, but now we're on the desktop finally. And it's time to install some drivers to get this thing into a working machine. Because currently, as you can see, everything's a bit blown up. In with the graphics driver. I'll speed this all up because it's taken a while. Now Now, as you can see, the graphics driver's installed fine because the monitor's a lot sharper now. It's no longer blown up like before, which is awesome to see. Now we're going to start installing our wallpaper, and this is a cool little tool, Tweaks Logon. Now, it allows you basically to change your login screen or the lock screen of Windows, because usually it's that default blue Windows background, but like you can see here, but I'm going to change it to the same one as my wallpaper. That way when I unlock the machine from asleep, it's seamless. The wallpaper doesn't have to change. So we'll select that one. Usually it likes a smaller file, but it doesn't matter if you've got a big one because it'll convert it for you. Off you go, and give it a test to make sure. And that's what I mean. It basically just makes that lock screen that you would usually have with a different wallpaper rather than the blue one, one of your choice. So you go in and now it's a seamless transition into your desktop. The mic Oldfield is working very well, which is the thing I use to test all my machines. The Taurus is sounding great. And we don't have to install any sound drivers by the looks of it, which is awesome. To test the video and make sure that that's all working, we're going to run a bit of Doctor Who. I don't own any of this, disclaimer. But now the Doctor Who's running fine, 60 FPS, and the audio's coming through nice and clear. So basically now I'm going to install some games and other things that we can use to test the machine. And here's Quake. Now Quake is running, it's a very, very old game admittedly, and it'll run on almost anything. But I like a game to run quite smooth, and it wasn't running as smooth as it could before on integrated. But and now it looks like we're getting, you know, more than 90 frames per second there on the demo. Yeah, around an average of 91 frames per second. And that's all on the highest settings with a pretty good resolution on this monitor. So I'm pretty impressed with that. Now once again, Trackmania Nations is another game I play quite a bit. And on that game, we're getting a pretty consistent frame rate, but this is running on very high settings with VSync as well, so keep that in mind. Now on Halo, we're getting incredible performance, and this is another game I play a lot. I know I'm not really pushing it that much, but we're getting some pretty high frame rates. I just saw it hit 400 at one point. But it's around an average when you're throwing grenades all the time of about 150 frames per second. Now, Counter-Strike, this is once again a very old game, but it's a game I play a lot, and if it doesn't run smooth, it's not good. So, and we're getting 60 frames per second, and it hasn't dropped below that at the most busiest of times. Now, the last step is I'm going to label this machine, and then this machine will be a fully fledged one of my fleet. And there you are, Ardug. Welcome to the family, bud. I hope you really enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching. And if you like this kind of content, do subscribe or make a request, and I'm happy to make a video for you. If you live in Sydney, I'll even build a computer for you if you'd like. Anyway, thanks for watching and have a good day.